Try it now. Am I good? For some reason, my mic wasn't on. Yeah, alright. And also, it looks like that delay isn't as bad this evening. Anyway, what I was going to say was, that sucks that your day didn't go very well, Cosme. I had a pretty easy day as far as substitute teaching goes. All the students did their work. Most of them got it done. And whenever they were done, that's it. They just you know, sat quietly on their phones or whatever, just talked. It was so fucking chill. Also, I'm sucking on a cough drop because I have had sinus draining all goddamn day, and I don't know why. Schoolwork sucked. Did the lectures, then the program fucked off and messed up. Then my mom made issues with my ex-boss. Oh, that sucks. Might get banned due to her. Oh my god, man, your mom, like, why would they judge based on something your fucking mom said? Like, that's, she's not you. Yeah, I'm sure she does. That sucks, dude. I hate it for you, Fortnite man. Damn. Fucking hate sinus draining. I'm assuming that's what this is. Either way. Okay. What the fuck? Oh, let me see if I can. No, that doesn't work either. This just needs to be wider or something. There we go. That's better. There we are. That's fantastic. Okay, I needed to widen my chat box. Man's plasma is fighting back. Bro, don't even. That ain't how that works. If anything, I'd be feeling better because the IV solution they gave you is just like a mixture of water, sodium, and a few other things to like really rehydrate you. I don't know what it is. At least Hall's cherry cough drops are tasty. And I had lo mein for dinner, which was heavenly. I threw a picture of it into Cap'n Morgan's Discord server. It's lo mein. Not like that. That's not spelled like that, and you know it. But yeah, there's a local Asian food place near my house. It's like 5 minutes away. What about high side? That sounds like a fucking 90s drink. Are you kidding me? Oh, I love Sky Hill. Waking up from a dream too soon. Waking up is like howling at the moon. Women out is like howling at the moon. Oh god, I fucking love him. When everything's got you down, pick yourself up and rise up high with high side. For fucking real, no, that sounds like a fucking alcoholic beverage or something. Like, it sounds like high, it sounds like the juice high C, but mixed with alcohol. It's like hard high C, but you can't name it hard high C, so you just call it high side. There's $1 million. They have spiked high C? Where the fuck did it, what? Is it by the same company? Crazy if so. Because high C used to be like aimed at children. And then again, those same children that were their audience are now adults. But no, that's Sunny. They made alcoholic Sunny D? What the hell? No, hi, sir. My boy! Wait, you said wait and no, that's Sunny D. I'm assuming you were correcting yourself. God damn it. It's Sunny D spiked, not High C. Oh, okay. How do you confuse them? Sunny D is basically orange juice, and High C has multiple flavors, which I still don't know why the orange High C is the only flavor that I ever see anymore. I hate orange High C. Both have a letter at the end as... Oh, yeah, true. I mean, High C comes before Sunny D on the alphabet, you know, alphabetically, if we're just looking at the letters. But, you know, you're also missing one point, and that is Sunny D's nuts. And with that, I'll show you what we're doing this evening. Sunny D was cheaper. Yes, it was. This evening, we're going to be looking at a bunch of Donkey Kong stuff. Because why the fuck not? Also, let me know if the music's too loud. Rhythm is like howling at the moon. No, not the TV show. Ain't no banana slammer coming on around here. Hell no. So, I will be skipping over some, because some of these I will be actually playing. I'm not going to play Donkey Kong Country 1, 2, or 3. I don't like them that much. I haven't beaten 2 yet. Even with save states, it's so fucking hard. I barely beat the first one with save states. Let's see. I'm not gonna play Tropical Freeze. Adobe Flash. What? Crazy. Wow, Mario vs. Donkey Kong. Donkey. Wow, there were 3 of them damn things. Damn. All right. Anyway, let's see. Oh wow, Atari 8-bit. That's funny. Dudley Curve. Junior Math. Hilarious. Those were Flash games for the Nintendo Store. Oh, I didn't know that was a thing. 1 and 2 in the US, 3 in Japan. Only, and all 3 in Japan had different songs. I think I would have preferred the Japanese version. Because then I wouldn't have had to deal with a fucking conga version of Louie Louie. Ugh. Anyway. Ah, fuck it. We'll start with the Country series. Why not? Visually, I've always liked the Japanese version. It has Chala Head Chala! Oh, that's awesome. Head Chala! Nani ga achibachi suru wa! Hello, hello, ha! Oh, it's fucking great. I love how goofy it is. Sparking! Alright. Oh, you can't see it, but there's an old trophy over here. And it's because it was a featured article. Okay. Donkey Kong Country combines monkeys, bananas, and barrels into one package for the first time in human history. I fucking love how sarcastic and dumb these fucking descriptions are sometimes. Wait, does this one also have a... Okay, never mind. You should play the DBZ RPG games on SNES. I don't know, man. I'm not a huge fan of Dragon Ball Z. Like, I grew up with it for sure. Like, I grew up watching all the way. I grew up liking GT. At least some of the episodes. Also, I'm drinking the coconut. Damn it. I'm drinking the coconut berry Red Bull, which is a go-to for me. I love the coconut Red Bull. Oops. Oh, it's Garoud. Garoud? Either way. He did the sound. He does indie game soundtracks, and he does a phenomenal job. Okay. Definitely more bear than coconut. And the coconut's very subdued. I'm pop some G Fuel tonight and stay up as an all-nighter to get as much work done as possible. Alright, dude. Good luck. And, while you're staying up, you're gonna need some entertainment to keep you awake, right? Something to play in the background, like, my VODs. How's that for a fucking segue? Seamless, that's what it is. Actually fair. I mean, hey, if you legit just want to have my fucking rambly ass voice on in the background while you do homework, by all means, dude, Godspeed. Okay. What subpages do we got? I hope it's a lot. Oh, never mind. Oh, wait. Look at this! Look at the spinny! Look at the spinny horn! He's dootin' all over the place. Oh my god. What the fuck? Okay, pre-release info, the regular notes. Unused bonus. Oh, by the way, Cosme. I don't know if redeems are working still. Hold on, let me see. I wonder if I can do one for myself. Okay, they are working. At least for me, they are working. So, that's a good sign. Okay, unused bonus room layouts. Unused object graphics, which, judging by the horn, do they work? So far, yes. The highlight message does work. Thank you. Judging by this spinning horn alone, I think we're going to find some good shit in here. Unused objects, subtypes, and version difference. The version differences has its own fucking page. God damn, you got some unused oh my god, dude. Also, if you can see my mouse up here in the top right-hand corner, where my mouse is right now, that's where we are on the page. And that, the little scroll marker is tiny. There's a lot of shit here. This is probably going to take the entire stream, and we're not even going to get through it all. I cannot wait. I love long pages like this. I love doing brick wars. All right. Look at the boy! Oh my god, he looks really fucking weird right there. What the fuck is that face?
I know where your daughter lives. And my finger and all of my toes are prehensile.
What a fucking face! What a fucking face! Oh my god, that's the thumbnail right there. Oh, I fucked your mom, shit. Is that a reference to something? If so, hilarious. Oh, look at this silly little man. I love that. I can't tell what that says. No thoughts, head empty. Oh, that's phenomenal. Hold on, I want to see if I can get a bigger picture of it. I hope so. No, there's nothing in a better quality, but look at this fucking face! I fucked your mom. Oh, the Lightning McQueen. Oh, yeah, that's right. I fucked your mom, shit lips. Oh, I just realized the third guy has a little hat on. This was a great decision. I am very happy with my choice. Holy shit. It's the three goobers. Like, here. Let me give it some time. That's the thumbnail. That's the thumbnail. Okay. Also, let me change the title so we can specify. Looking through... Cut content from... Donkey Kong Country. What are these fake bells? Oh, it's a satanic place of worship from Clock Tower. Hell yeah. I feel like if I had a walkthrough, I think I could get through that game. It seems really cool. It's like one of the first and one of the only survival horror games on SNES. It's crazy. Anyway, yeah. The Goobers. Alright. What else we got here? Yeah, okay. That's a little closer to his final design. This one is just... He has no neck. No neck is to be found here. Bring something in lightly feet inward. Oh, they're bringing his feet in. Oh my god, that's still so fucking awful looking. Is that... Oh, it's Nanary. I thought it was Apex Twin for a second. Wait, hold on. I don't know if I've noticed it yet or not. God damn it. Ugh. Okay. My chat's messed up again. This one's fine, thank God. Okay. Copy. Cancel posture check. Thank you. Ugh, Cosme. Yeah, okay. I control Z'd while I was in OBS. Yeah, that's what I was talking about. I noticed it before, and I control Z'd to get back to my regular model, but that reversed my last action though in OBS, which was to mute myself. And so I got muted. Thankfully, it didn't happen for that long. Either way, I have to fix the chat real quick because I hate it. It hates me. My man muted. Yeah, my man muted it. Your boy muted himself. God fucking damn it. All right, fine. I have to go into. Where are you? I really should pin. Why the fuck is there Home Depot down here? Fuck you, Home Depot. Fuck you, Amazon. I do like that if there's no icon for the website, they give you, like, the first letter for the website. That's really cool. Anyway, getting distracted. You get to see behind the veneer. Where are you? There you are, you bastard. God! Oh, God. Since I have an extra stocking card from some China. Wait, huh? If I make a food deck for MTG, should I use stocking from Panty and Stocking as a food token for the show? I mean, go for it, man. If the table allows it, I don't see why not. Don't see why not. Just asking if it would be. I mean, I think it would. Then again, not everyone would get the joke. You know? I feel like if you do something directly food-related, it might be cool. Yeah. Also, the Lord of the Rings Food and Fellowship deck would be perfect. Because it is essentially, food tribal. Ugh. I might actually send you my deck. My Food and Fellowship Commander deck, because I'm not using it. And I don't plan on using it ever. It's not my thing. Where are you? Oh yeah, before I could even stream yesterday, someone named Dim Something followed me, which was very nice. Gonna finish up my decks, that's where I know the list. What list? No, I'm talking about, like, my pre-con. My Lord of the Rings pre-con with, damn it. Not the Food and Fellowship pre-con with the two main characters of Lord of the Rings whose name are escaping me. Frodo and Sam, thank you. Thank you, Cosme. Oh my God, that was bugging the shit out of me. And I only remember Sam because I have a friend named Sam. Okay, let's see. All widgets. I think that's right. That's not right. Alert box. No. Where are you? Cloudbot App Store. Where the hell is my thing? Where's my, Bella stuff? Thank you. I'm trying to find my chat box, but I can't fucking find it! Ugh. I'm gonna have to re-fucking do it. Again. Okay, 730 by 350. Actually, I wonder if I can just delete this and then redo it. Nope, it does, of course it doesn't work like that. That'd be silly. That'd be too fucking easy. Ugh.
730 by 350. Party till I die.
Oh, it's Nick Johnston. Sweet. All right, anyway.
Okay, so. Get some goddamn.
Okay. Mm-hmm, that works. Okay. Move this down here. There we go. Fuck you, fucking Streamlabs. Can't even find my fucking. Ugh. No, not overlays. Is it all the widgets? Let me check real quick. I probably just fucking didn't notice. Ah! Where'd you go? Yeah. Oh my god. All of the scuffy wuffies. God damn it. There will be scuff. Coming to a theater near you, circa 1992. Ugh. Okay. All the alert box. Cloud Redemption. What in the fuck, dude? Yeah, I'll have to figure it out later. This is fucking dumb. Let's get back to Dirtly Curd. God damn it. Temst. That's how Temmy tests her streams, is by going Temst. Anyway. These early sketches of Donkey Kong are from 1993 and have more slim limbs. This was more Miyamoto suggested adding it. This was before Miyamoto suggested adding a tie. Miyamoto's the reason why Dirtly Curd has a tie. If you got any funny scenes, send them my way too. I can try and make them emoji. Oh, absolutely. He got his toy. Huh? What toy? What are you talking about? Toy? Oh, he got his tie. He got his toy! Like the like fucking Midwest ass. Okay. You got your toy! Oh, it's so good. Okay. Early character sketches. A Midwest ass sometimes million. Who? I'll take your word for it. Kevin Bayless, one of the game's artists, shows off his early. Oh, okay. Yeah, I get you. Sketches of characters, including early iterations, known characters, and some discarded ideas. Ooh. Oh, I was hoping this was hot milk. Boop, 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 boop. boop boop weep boop weep boop. I love that song. It's also a great meme. All right, what do we got? What you got, Mr. Bayless?
This is the second video in my series where I take a look at some of my old concept art, and today we're doing Donkey Kong Country. In case you didn't know, Donkey Kong Country is one of the first games to feature pre-rendered graphics. The process basically involves scribbling down ideas, building a 3D model, and then converting that 3D model by rendering it out as a sprite. The overall effect was absolutely mind-blowing and way ahead of its time, and Rare were one of the first companies to produce graphics this way. And I was very lucky because I was given the opportunity to recreate Shigeru Miyamoto's Donkey Kong character for the game. I really didn't think there was anything wrong with a Donkey Kong character in the first place, but when I got the chance to recreate him, I was really excited about it. So these are the original sketches. There's nothing super glamorous here, they're just scribbles on pieces of paper. But they're really important because it shows how the characters were developed from an early stage. I mean, some of these characters are swinging around in the jungle today. They just look a lot slicker. So without further ado, delve in and take a look. And remember, hit that subscribe button if you want to see more videos with more stuff like this. So here are the original scribbles, which were used as a basis for us to model our 3D graphics Winky. For Donkey Kong Country. There's not a lot here, really. It's just a lot.
What a silly... Whoops.
As I say, they're very crude, but it was all...
What a silly lad. His name's Winky, because he's a frog who winks. Paddle, hi, welcome. Welcome, welcome. I'm looking through pre-release stuff for the original Donkey Kong Country. I love them in concept. I'm so bad at 2D platformers, I could never play them on stream. I don't think I would have any fun doing it. But yes, we're looking through early concept art. This is Winky, which is a very silly name for a frog.
Back in the day, before we began modeling characters up, we just needed a couple of sketches so that we could refer to them and say, yeah, we want a frog. And then we'd probably consult our natural history books or whatever we had on our desks way before the internet. And we'd look at all the finer details and take that information from the books. But yeah, the basis of our...
If you have a Switch, you can play with save states. I did. I beat Donkey Kong Country 1 on the Switch with save states. And it was horrible. That game is so hard. It's so hard, I don't want to replay it. I haven't beaten DKC2 yet either. Even with save states, that shit's hard. Oh my god, it feels like I'm performing fucking surgery. The platforming is so precise. God damn. Fair, I tried it with it. I did the glitch for the infinite life. I don't remember the infinite life glitch, but that's awesome. It's so, yeah. Oh yeah, DKC2 is even harder. Oh my god. I still don't know why Gerard the Completionist claims it as his favorite game of all time. I even played DK's Donkey Kong 64, but I own it. Hey, I own it too. I have never beaten it, but I love it enough to... What's probably going to happen is I'll play it on stream, and I'll get to the very end where I've done all the levels, but I haven't gotten the secret tokens from the fucking old arcade games. And so, I'll just fucking look up the ending online. DK1 is pretty easy for me. Donkey Kong Country 1? The one level was a pain. I haven't gotten past a specific level. I hate Crash. Though, I get... Huh? Like Crash Bandicoot? I mean, if so, I get it. Although, I had more fun playing Crash 1, playing the Crash trilogy than I did with Donkey Kong Country. It does have banger soundtracks, and soundtracks can carry. I mean, you're not wrong. DKC's got some great soundtracks. I got stuck on a level in Crash 1 and my game drifts. Oh, that sucks, dude. Like, my controller is fine, but Crash walks the other way. That doesn't sound like your controller's fine, dude. I don't see what else could be the problem.
Ideas for... The characters would start off something like this, and as you can see, these are the roughest of sketches. I mean, if you were to present this as concept art nowadays, people would just laugh at you, but it was enough and it did the job for us back in the day. So that's Winky the Frog, and here we've got Rambi, it was originally. I've got written down here.
If it's a brand new controller, then the controller itself is probably faulty. If you still have the receipt, I would still get a refund. Like, there, sometimes you just get a bad one. It happens with mass production, which sucks ass. But it does happen.
Right, awesome.
Like, I bought a relatively new, but it was like second, not second hand, but it was a, oh, what is it? It's those cheap PS2 controllers that are like not name brand. I might uninstall the game and retry it since it's just so. I mean, maybe. Oh, if it's a digital copy, then there's more room for error, I think, when it comes to like fucking stuff up. Because my friend who had a Switch, she had a bunch of. Does it work fine on other game in other games? Oh yeah, that's true. If the controller works fine with other game, it works perfectly on my Switch. No, we're talking about the PS4 controller, Cosme. If your PS4 controller works fine with other games, then you're right. It may not be the controller. Oh, look at Rambi.
I think it's quite a cool name, really. I think I did actually share this picture a little while ago, so I wrote what it was on there. But yeah, I think he was originally intended to have a saddle on him.
Oh, you never said PS4? Playing digital. Oh, it might be the Switch then, because my friend, she used to get a lot of digital games on Switch, and I kind of warned her about it. I warned her about, you know, the digital thing, and she's like, no, it'll be fine. And one day she realized that all of her games were glitching out, and she had to delete all of her digital games and then re-download them, because her micro SD card had fucked up. So just be careful about that.
He's got one single horn there. I can't remember whether he ended up with two horns or just a single horn. These stupid hairs on him. Everything just looked kind of silly, really, originally. And
yes, you should do physical stuff if you care.
Everything developed its own kind of style.
That's why I'm getting a physical copy of Bomb Rush Cyberpunk.
Eyes here.
Or I pre-ordered it anyway.
Looking version of the character. But that was Rambi. And we've got Espresso the Ostrich.
Espresso!
Fairly generic looking bird character here. A few notes on here just says bigger, wider, longer. That's about as much information as we'd ever put on anything. Sorry, I'm going all over.
Look at that
place,
silly please. Boy!
Just lots of silly scribbles. And then they were, of course, turned into 3D models. Yeah. I think there was a decision to put trainers on him here. So this is very early sketch. So these are the faxes which came over from Nintendo to help us design or redesign the Donkey Kong character and come up with the companion Diddy Kong.
Why is that censored, I wonder?
They were very, very helpful. And as you can see, there's just a selection of different DK pictures.
That, yeah, half of that, most of that's censored. That's weird.
To refer to. I think they wanted us to change his proportion so that he worked better as a platformer. Rather than a villain at the top of the screen, and the rest is history. But these are quite significant because these are the faxes which change the face and shape.
Like it's only a circle that's clear; the rest of it's blurry. That's real fucking weird.
We've got a snake character here.
Slip us.
Looks as though I was going to call them silly names: Spitz, Snort.
Oh.
Whistling by the.
Oh, what a silly boy!
Some kind of noise with his rattle, maybe.
Oh, I love him.
I think I wanted him to. Perhaps hypnotize you as you approach them.
That'd be adorable.
Develop a hood on them. So
oh, that's I don't know awesome. I hope y'all can see this okay. Spits, it looks a little weird on my stream preview.
Out in front of you, spits venom, hop foot, momentarily stuns Kong and reduces his energy.
Damn.
It comes out of the trees like this. I don't know whether we actually did that.
He's in the trees, man.
Aggressive looking snakes. So. Spitter snakes, different to normal. Move along, snake. Hood lifts up and
move
spits
along.
And stuns you. Quality. So here's the Donkey Kong character. There's not a lot of sketches here, but these are just pencil sketches underneath the actually original pencil sketches, which I scribbled down to use as, I think, an image plane, which would have been imported into Maya, which was Power Animator at the time.
You may slap the booty once. Oh, I can't believe I remember that. Fuck yeah. You may slap the booty once. Oh, I love that meme. It's circle in the booty.
The 3D model, so you needed a front and a side and a back view of the character, and these were what I used as my original reference. So there's the original design, which looks fantastic.
His lighting is so bad.
And there's my kind of cubic design there. It's quite boxy.
Yeah, it is kind of boxy.
To sit well in a 3D platforming environment, and we didn't want any bits overhanging. We needed to make sure that it played well and there was good hits, and so we wanted to keep him quite sort of boxy and sort of nice and compact.
Yeah.
Also, I think because I did a lot of NES graphics, I got that used to making things in a very compact manner and trying to keep as few sprites as possible. So I think there was a tendency for me to design the characters quite sort of boxy. And
foxy,
then,
boxy.
As you can see, here's the very crude looking DK.
Hell yeah.
Which, can see how his joints here don't blend from one part into another organically.
Oh, okay.
Sort of spheres.
It looks like he's wearing a long sleeve shirt. It just looks like a dude with a like a fucking mask on, and like he's wearing like a brown shirt, but the sleeves are too short. Can't unsee it now, god damn it. He's like, my sleeves too short, I feel like they're too short. And he's like, no dude, you're fine, let's go to the party. Like, are you sure? I feel like they're too short. And he's like, no, you're fine, dude. Oh my god, I can't unsee it now. Holy shit.
And lots of sorts of primitive.
Also, this is apparently from DK Creations UK. Only 2.7 thousand subscribers. Wow. Straight from the maker of Donkey Kong himself, and he's got less than 500,000. Such a shame. I may look him up later.
Primitive shapes put together, and I think we trimmed. There was a feature which allowed us to trim overlay and shapes.
Damn it!
So that gave him these kind.
Oy, oy, oy. Here we are.
Looks crude here, but when it was scaled down into sort of 64 by 32 pixels or whatever size he was, you didn't see all of these little joins. And when it was also only using 16 colors, the whole thing looked great. So yeah, these are the pictures that we used to model the character. It's got a much bigger head there.
Yeah, it's huge head.
On my original sketch.
The fuck? That head is gigantic.
Much bigger than the head he's got.
Fucking Jughead ass.
And there's another design. He's very, very Battletoad-esque. Little ideas there, every beat in his chest.
Yo!
And then finally here,
what
the Kremlin characters.
Fuck is that? Why is he like a fucking rope? Why is he like a snake with... Is he just like a buff snake with legs? That's really weird looking. What in the hell?
So obviously it's some kind of mutant crocodile, but this was actually intended for another game way before we started working on Donkey Kong Country. And I think we sort of carried the idea of the Kremlin sort of race, if you like.
Eepy Frog and Flop. Hello, Aiden. I hope you're doing okay. I don't know if you woke up from a nap. If you did, I'm glad you got rested. If you haven't slept at all, I hope you're able to get some sleep. Thank you for being here. We're looking through some early Donkey Kong Country stuff, and these were apparently going to be the fucking Kremlings. I just got home. Damn. All right. Oh no. Well, sit back if you can. Relax if you have time. It'll be all right. I hope you're able to relax at all. That's all I want for you at this point. I know the gremlins can give you the runaround. Tis the plan. Good, 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 good. But yeah, look at this weird-ass fucking Kremlin in the early stages of Donkey Kong Country. It looks like a fucking snake with arms and legs. And, pecs. A snake with pecs. Anyway.
They'll fit quite nicely in the jungle, and so we'll develop these characters and turn them into the Kremlins that you know of today.
I like that one.
You can see some of the skin.
I love that one. That one's so goofy. He's so weird. Also, I need to show you the three goobers from earlier in the page. there were three early concept designs for Donkey Kong, either Donkey Kong or Diddy Kong, one of the two, and all three of them just look so fucking goofy. I love it.
Sketches here were very crude and very sketchy, but they're also very compact, just like
he angy.
So I think
there's the army helmet.
They intended them to look like little soldiers, and they got sort of And yeah, I think that'll do for today. I think we've had a quick look.
Hydrate and stretch. Thank you, Aiden. Also, the redeems are working. Yeah. Okay, so I have drank. I got me a coconut berry Red Bull, and the coconut does not overpower, and I'm so happy. Cosby, stop! I will take one sip. And now, we stretch. Oy, oy, oy. I'm still sad that I wasn't able to stream last night, because that's when Gloop Queen streams, and I wanted to raid her. She's super cool and really, really cute, and I love the way her voice sounds. It's fantastic. Oh, yeah.
Taps on.
He was done with that. So we go back down to the volume, and we go back to Snail's house. Okay. Oh, yeah. Look at the goobers. Akon got a crush. I'm sorry. Crushing these nuts? I know that makes no sense. I appreciate cute. Ah, oh, itchy. But yeah, Aiden, it's the three goobers. Into what? What the hell are you talking about? Gloop Queen? Have you seen Gloop Queen? She's real cute. Crushing these no Cosme, but I will never skimp on an opportunity to make a D's Nuts joke, regardless of how little sense it makes. That's always been my bit. Well, at the very least, it's been my bit for at least 5 years. But yeah, the goobers. It's No Thoughts, Head Empty, Innocent Flower, and I almost said Dumpy, but that doesn't make sense. You don't even see his butt. But look at his hat. It's the Hat Man. He's the Hat Man. Skibbidi-bidi-bub-bub. Okay. I wish I had a higher quality image of that, but I don't. Also, this creepy version, he looks like he's having very, very bad thoughts about anyone he's looking at. And the toes do not help. The prehensile toes they just make it worse. The hat one looks like a monkey you'd see painted on the side of a zoo cotton candy machine with Yippie. Oh my god, Cosme, that's so specific. Specifically the German Yippie, the fucking Yippie! Mutz Nein und Cola! Fucking love that. I can't believe I thought Snuffy was the originator of that. She can emulate that sound so well. Time to crush the can. And I do have a smaller cup of the not-so-sweet tea, but I decided to treat myself today, and I got a cherry vanilla Coke. Und Cola! Yippee! I think I have that Yippee in my sound alerts. I don't remember. If I don't, I'm gonna fucking do that immediately as soon as I get done streaming. Fucking love that thing. Okay, SCES 1994 promotional video. Used for promoting DKC and the Super Game Boy. Here are some differences between this build and the final version. Ropey rampage with no lightning or rain. Poison Pond render.
No yippee sad.
Thank you, Cosme. No yippee sad. Alright, I'll have to find that one. Actually, I wonder if I can do it right now, like on my phone.
Eelabop.
Ooh. Whew. I tasted my low main with that one. God damn. Sound alerts. And while that's cool. Okay, poison pondering with blue water in background. The banana counter goes above 100 on ropey rampage. Do I sound sniffly? I'm starting to think I sound sniffly. I'm dying pasta too. Huh? I'm dying pasta too spicy. What spicy pasta you got, boy? Clump is not defeated by DK. Okay, what do we got? What the fuck? Hold on. I'm gonna pause the music with my phone. Hold on just a second. Oh, it does. Okay, it does have sound. Alright.
Check it out. Game Boy Classics on TV and in color.
Ugh.
Some wild jungle magic.
I wish I had this. Although, hold on. If I George of to jungle, no, it's not. Now that I think about it, the NSO Game Boy has a color feature, right? You can change the background and you can change the title card look. It did look like George of the Jungle in the title card, Cosme. You are right about that. But yeah, if I remember right, the Game Boy NSO. For games that are just regular Game Boy, yeah, but not the design around it. You sure? I remember being able to change the border. I don't know. I'll have to double check.
Players can work their own magic, turning any Game Boy game into a whole new game.
Oh my god, that's the dream right there. Turning the original Metroid 2 into color. I haven't seen the design themed specifically to the game. Oh, okay. Just generic ones. That's odd.
Players will be jamming to the big screen action.
Hell yeah.
Choose their own colors and design their own borders. Plus, Super Game Boy gives you stereo sound.
Let me know if y'all can hear that, by the way.
It's time to jungle.
That's so cool. Jungle Boogie? Come on.
Nintendo is turning up the volume with 8 million in Super Game Boy advertising. Why, it's a massive marketing.
Why would you, like, pat yourself on the back with how much you spent in advertising, unless this was not meant for people. Or, not people, you know what I mean? This was not meant, yeah, Jungle Boogie. Unless this was not meant for customers, this was meant for, like, executives or something. But if so, if it was meant for executives, why be so fucking showy about it? Just show, like, a fucking video of, like, just show a fucking picture on the screen, be like, yo, we spent $8 million in advertising, this shit's gonna work. I do like Kirby Pinball, though. It is a promo video. That's what I mean. If it's a promo video for I keep separating people from investors, but hey, investors aren't people. Oh, I kid. Economics are a joke. But yeah, if it's a promo meant for customers, why would they care that they spent $8 million? Promo doesn't equal ad. Yes, but normally a promo is meant for the eyes of customers, right? Like a promotional video? Or a promo foil for Magic the Gathering. Oh, by the way, Cosme, business people. Oh, okay, got you. By the way, Cosme, I finally downloaded and tried out Cockatrice. If you're not familiar with it, it is a free tabletop sim that specializes in specifically Magic the Gathering, but the UI is real fucking weird. Caca what? Cockatrice, the mythical creature. I swear to God, Automod, don't you dare. Nope, I misspelled that, God damn it. Not Cocktrice, cockatrice. There it is. Fucking cocktree. Cocktrees? You're being a real cockatrice. You're being a real cocktrice right now. Oh, boy. Yes, Cosme, cockatree. One tree of cock. Anyway. Oh, I get you, though. I want to download it sometime. I mean, it is free. It's just really fucking weird. Like, for instance, as far as I can tell, I don't know, is it worth it? I mean, it's free. It's a free thing. And it seems to be, like I said, the UI is very minimal. But the biggest downside for me is that there's no format selection. You just throw a deck together. And that, like, there's no specific zone for your commander. I might wait till you get used to it sometime, then build my... Yeah. But, like, it's... I mean, I got used to it a little bit last night, because I imported one of my decks there. And, but it was one of my commander decks, and there's no spot for your commander other than the sideboard. So you literally have to put your commander in the sideboard in order to keep it out of the main deck, which is really fucking weird, but you can access your sideboard at any time during a game. So I guess you just, you know, communicate with the other person, like, hey, we're doing commander. Commanders stay in the sideboard for this particular software, and you just go on like you normally do. But yeah, it's... the gameplay itself is... I tested a deck, and it's pretty intuitive. The only downside is that the battlefield's kind of small. But that's about it. I guess so. I might want to run a game with the... Abso-fucking-lutely, dude. I would love to play my 1994 deck and Blightblade deck against you. You'll get to see a bunch of old-ass cards and be like, what the fuck does that mean? Oh, I can't wait. Anyway. Phyrexian time. Uh-oh. Propaganda. Soul Cage, or the white version of Propaganda. Anyway. Damn it, I keep hitting space button to unpause the video whenever my cursor... Anyway. I love when he said it's Phyrexian time and Phyrexian all over them.
Check out the magic in this Super Game Boy TVS.
Super Game Boy.
It's coming.
What the fuck? Oh, I love how 90s this is. The Swordfish!
Super Game Boy from Nintendo. Play your Game Boy games on TV in living color. Combinations you choose, control, and change. All 350 Game Boy games like Donkey Kong.
There were only 350? Ghostly Prison, yes, thank you. Norn's Annex. Is that also one that does the same thing? Cool if so. But yeah, there were only 350 Game Boy games when this released. What the fuck?
No Super Game Boy for SNES. It's a whole new way to play.
Oh god, that's creepy.
With an installed base of 17 million for Game Boy and 15 million for Super NES, with 7 million players owning both, this product has giant potential. Players will go wild rediscovering their collection of hand...
Yeah, this definitely feels more like a business pitch than an advertisement. Intense pouting waifu had to go to work. Aww. I hope you were able to give her some lovin's. The, the affectionate version of lovin's. Also, I'm going to skip to where they actually show fucking Donkey Kong Country. Wait, hold on. This is a 3D truck game that was awful. Tetris 2? I forgot they had Tetris 2. Yo, is that fucking Illusion of Gaia? It is Illusion of Gaia! Yo. Hold up. I gotta see my boy Illusion of Gaia, which I do plan on emulating at some point since it's not on the fucking NSO.
We want an even bigger game. Like many others, we had heard tales of a mysterious place that would reveal the secrets of time and the true nature of fantasy.
Wow, look at that old logo. I managed to get a hug, so yeah. Good. Good, good, good. That logo's 90s as fuck. There is no swashbuckling action.
Talk to exotic characters.
as he explores mythical Will Power globe,
where he must uncover mystic icons of a lost age. As Will's powers grow, he learns to transform into freedom.
Transform.
Dark Knight and Shadow, the ultimate warrior. The adventure becomes even more spectacular when the flow of time weaves a future and a past.
I didn't know you could do that slide. That's cool.
Mixing with cunning characters and thrilling action. This huge 16 megabit game holds 3 battery backed memory slots.
Shoot! 16 megabytes. Oh, man. Oh, simpler times, 1994, the year I was born.
So 3 different players can save their adventures. If you enjoy the challenges of the Zelda series, you'll really
there it is.
By this jewel of a game.
That music does not sound like it's from Illusion of Gaia, although it may be from Illusion of Gaia, and I just don't remember.
The trek went on.
Fucking Wario's Woods. That's Super Punch Out. Unicycle thingy. The game that got sued. Where are you? Oh, here it is. Dirtly Kurg. There we are. Hell yeah. First fully rendered video game ever. Oh god, the flashing. Created on SGI computers. Silicon Graphics computers. Same ones who brought dinosaurs. Oh yeah, the fucking Jurassic Park. Featuring sidekick Diddley. Bo Diddley was Donkey Kong's sidekick. A lot of people don't know that. I thought it said tons of good boys. Tons more bad guys. He said tons of good guys and then showed 2 extra characters. What the fuck? Y'all want a pizza? What the... Wait, huh? Is that an actual... What the hell? Oh, that's... Oh, it's Domino's. Ew. It is free pizza though, but the closest Domino's to me is half an hour away, so it wouldn't get here in time. And I don't want to go to pick it up. Just gotta pay delivery. You mean the arm and a leg? I appreciate the offer though. Ugh! Too much flashing, Jesus. The one time that's a bad thing. But free medium pizza, I'm going to send it in the group chat. Good luck. Someone might be closer by. Not on 32. Random ass ostrich. Real life ostrich. And a bear, I think that was. Oh my god, there's too many flashing images. Why would they do this to our eyes? I forgot the 90s got this intense. Oh, it's a monkey. November 21st of 1994. Play it loud. There it is. There it is. Monkey D... What? Monkey D. Luffy. The fucking TikTok sound. Monkey D. Luffy. Alright. You said monkey. Monkey! Yes, but not that kind of monkey. Oh my god. Oh wait, no. Cosme, you're not caught up with the manga, are you? I stay caught up with it technically through like video chapter reviews of the newest chapters, so I know what's going on currently, but I'm not there reading wise. Okay, then I will not tell you specifically what happens. It is the darkest chapter in One Piece so far. Holy fucking shit, dude. But yeah, that's all I'll say. It's the darkest chapter Oda's ever done. Dumb drum battle. Oh, okay. What did Luffy kill? What did Luffy kill Kaido and Big Mom or something? No. They're past that. They have moved on from Wano, and they are on a new island with new characters. And shit's getting real fucking crazy. Yeah, I'm not gonna say anything more, though. Anyway, Boss Dumdrum would originally have been fought in a room, much like the bonus rooms. However, he was moved elsewhere in the final game. The original room still exists in the ROM, room ID 21, but without the boss itself. Apparently they might go to space at some point, I guess. That's all I've heard. Has that been confirmed by Oda? Because if not, then that's someone just making speculation. People only think that because there's a cover story with NL from Skypiea, a couple chapters later. The outfits from Egghead Island, that too. I mean, yeah, but like, I feel like that's just a style choice. You know how Oda gets. Oh, they were gonna name the owl Hooter. Mole Mini Cloak the Kremlin Magician. I heard Anel is on the moon too. That would be hilarious if he can't escape Luffy. Yeah, Anel went to the fucking moon and found a bunch of little tiny people there. That was in a cover story. What do you see? What happens to Wapple if you haven't? If I can't remember if that cover story is during the Skypiea arc or not, but Wapple gets some. Wapple winds up a very pivotal character later in the series, which is hilarious. And he becomes not a jackass. But it's up to you to read his cover story to see his fall from grace. Oh, the Wapple Medal and the Lady Who Laughed. Yeah, the Wapple Medal. Okay, so you do know about that. Cloak, Crumble, Crocobot. I still love Hooter. They're like, please let us get away with this. Please let us get away with this. I saw stuff with the cover stories on YouTube. Oh, okay. A naming sheet posted by Greg Males on Twitter, dated March 8th, 1994. That was... 2 months... No. 1 month and... Oh. What's 22 minus 8? 2... 1, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14. So that's 2 months and about 14 days before I was born. Since the only ones animated are the Kobe one and the one with Buggy. Yeah, I kind of wish they would animate more cover stories. That would make, technically it would be filler, but at the same time, it would be canon, which would make it even greater, even better. Fucking grit. Anyway. 1994. It didn't do so well back then, so they didn't do them. Probably because people who watched the anime thought it was just a filler and not, like, canon to the manga. Anyway. 1994 reveals that the game was originally called Donkey Kong's Monkey Mayhem. Weird. It also shows that the technique Rare used for the 3D art in this game was, to be named Render FX or RFX instead of Advanced Computer Modeling, ACM. I mean, Render FX sounds cooler. Candy Kong was originally Honey Kong, or Blondie Kong, which is a dumbass name. King K. Rool was Commander K. Rool. Rock Croc was Croc Rock. Hilarious. I kind of wish they had just taken out that first R and called it Cock Rock. Slippo was Mr. Hister. Hilarious. Squidge had the honorific Mr. Squidge. And Clambo was Miss Calamity. Oh, man. Unused concepts revealed in this sheet include an eel named Mobo. Hilarious. A fireball named Fizzle, a yeti named Frozone. But where is his super suit? A fish named Bloop and Gloop. Hilarious. A nasty beetle, quote-unquote, named Vidub. A Kremlin named Clanger. Hey, Clanger's Cavern. A robot Kremlin named Crockbot, and a statue Kremlin named Crumble.
It also shows two unused animal friends, an owl named Hooter, hilarious, and a mole named Miney or Minnie, one of the two. Despite being cut from the original game, Shuri, Puffed-Up, Cloak, and the Beetle, renamed Click Clack, made it into DKC2. A fish enemy named Gloop later appeared in Donkey Kong Land, which I never have played, though it's unclear if it's connected to the Gloop scene here. Characters missing from the list who appear in the final version are Squawks, the parrot, Bite Size, the piranha, Chomps Jr., the little shark, Naughty, the beaver, who also shows up in Banjo-Kazooie, and Mankey Kong, orangutan. Oh yeah, Mankey. Wait, oh no, that's a Pokemon. It's possible Squawks took Hooter's planned role, while Bite Size and Chomps Jr. replaced Bloop and Gloop. Yeah, that's fair. Okay. Unused bonus room layouts. Also, for the shits and giggles, let's just see if there's anything fun in the notes section. I doubt there is. There usually never is. Yep, that's... Okay, so the notes are always just text. I'm not gonna sit there reading it like a fucking textbook. Ooh. I need some fucking throat coat, but I don't know where to get it. I can get it at the local dollar store, but... We'll see. I'm still Andy's favorite toy. I love doing that.
Werebear, green, one colorless mana, one green mana. Creature druid bear. Tap, add one green mana, 1/1. He exercises his right to bear arms.
Oh, I love that. Green, one colorless mana. Two mana for a green for a 1/1 mana dork, bro. I thought it would be a good theme card. I mean, honestly, there's already a card that's basically that, but replace the bear with an elk, I think it is, or a deer of some kind. Either way, it's a 2-mana mana dork that's an animal. I have a copy of it somewhere in my binder somewhere. It's not good. Again, 2 mana is already too much for a mana dork. There are a number of bonus room layouts that remain unused in the game. That was funny since it... the text-to-speech was fucking great. I love that. I'm not faulting you for that. The only way to access them is to modify stage boundaries... They don't have room IDs. That's a long boy. If ever there was one... Here, let me zoom in more. Okay, this one is a bonus room with a layout that's unlike anything else in the game. This would have been populated with either a blast barrel or bouncy tires, as it is, the room has no objects. I'm assuming it means this one. And then there's that one, which... I don't know, I'm getting board game vibes from it. Weird. Also, the band that's playing right now goes by Blut aus Nord. I got an atmospheric black metal band that swap between no vocals and vocals, but either way, I think they're great. And they're independent. A bonus room with 4 item caches, I guess that's what those are, located directly after a bonus room used in the game. A room with 3 item caches. This would probably show up in Orange... Huh? Oh, Orangutan Gang. Jesus. The fucking dash threw me off. Oh my god. Orangutan Gang, which had 3 bonus rooms like this. It was replaced with either the Animal Token bonus room or the Espresso one. I swear that ostrich's name is the reason why people think Espresso is pronounced Expresso. Oh my god. God, that's a great background. Wow. I think it's a PNG as well. Hold up. Oh, it is. Dude, it's a PNG background. Oh, that's so cool. Be like, yo, what up? I'm just chilling out here in my fucking cave. Dude, oh my god. If I could find like a background to go behind that, Cosme, I would love to have you make some to make like a background a back. I don't have Photoshop and I don't know how to use it. I don't even know how to use GIMP. Hilarious name though. I'll save this just in case though. Yeah, I can make something. Yeah, okay. Like I said, the center part back there is a PNG, so you might can find something that's free. You want me to just put the gemstone caverns as the backdrop? Is that the one from? I mean, if it's Donkey Kong Country related, yeah, sure, I can use that. I'm not sure what I'll use the background for, but we'll use it for something one of these days. Oh, I'm an MTG. Ooh, that's a good idea. If you can find like a high res enough version of that, that might be a cool idea. Absolutely. Yeah, oh, I remember the gem. Dude, I cannot believe that fucking land is worth $30 to $50. I can search one for my friend. Yeah, I would recommend Scryfall. They usually have high res, both cropped and uncropped cards and a card art. Scryfall.com. Great website. Ooh, that's another good one. That's why I want to make a proxy with Patrick as a, in a mine with gemstones around him. What the fuck? That one's too wide. But yeah, I cannot believe a fucking... The only reason why gemstone mine is worth 50 goddamn dollars is just based on the random chance that you will draw it in your opening hand. That's it. If it didn't have that random chance aspect to it, it'd be fucking worthless. And that's so dumb to me. Like, I sold it. I refused to use it. Like, it's so dumb. The odds of me pulling that in any of my commander decks is 1 in 99. And them ain't good odds. At least not in my opinion. Here's something interesting. Thank you, author. These item cache holes don't appear in any other cave area. Sweet, there's six of them. Graphics for them for the item cache coverings are in the game, but never used. Shit. Ooh, I like this one. This one's super cool. Whole ass background right here. That's why I want to make a proxy with Patrick in the mine gemstones around. That's fair. By the way, Cosme, did you know that thanks to the new Ixalan set, Pitiless Plunderer has gone from $10 to $3? I'm so fucking excited about that. I love Pitiless Plunderer, but it has not been worth $10. I'm so happy it's down to $3 to $4. That's so much more affordable. Yes, you can afford one. I'm so happy. I found it yesterday whenever I was looking for more pirates to put into my pirate commander deck, and I was so fucking happy when I saw it. I was like, oh, it's down to $4. Yes. Oh my god. And it's only the reprint that's down to $3. All the other older printings are still $10, which is really fucking weird. But yeah, I'm so happy about that. Oh my god, I'm so happy about that. Also, one of the members of the of our private magic discussion server realized that I don't know if you saw it in my rules question in the rules question section, but he managed to figure out that if you combine Helm of the Host with Ogier, the new mono white god from the new Ixalan set, you can quadruple, not even quad, you can essentially 3x3x3 tokens. Hoo boy, it's gonna get wide. And I can already see Helm of the Host going up in price. Hell, Ogier's already $38. Ugh, I really hate. Hey, I don't. Hold on. I don't think my dad realized I was streaming. I hope neither of y'all heard him. He can be very loud. If you heard mumbling, that's fine. Anyway,
God damn it, train of thought.
Ixalan. Gods. Expensive. Yeah, also, the fucking power creep is real obvious in this new Ixalan set. And a good example of that is the new version of Britches, the monkey. Because in Commander Masters from a year or two ago, that Breaches is 4 mana for a 2/2, I believe. I want to get some of it, but I probably won't be able to for a while. Yeah, that's fair. I mean, hey, like I said, see if you can find another LGS in your area. Especially ones who are willing to talk to you about what happened at the shop, at that other shop. Because, like, you know, I will be surprised if the other shops are as quick to judge as the place that you used to work at, because that's just unacceptable. It's not how you run a fucking business. Wait, what was that? Oh, unused mines bonus room. Okay. A simple room with a slope in the middle, something that would have been filled with nanners and or extra lives. They did the deal with the guy, and I haven't gotten my $20 yet still for what I purchased on it. Oh, see, now they're cheating you out of money. Like, legit, though, I will be surprised if you try to go somewhere else and they aren't understanding or at least listen to what you have to say. These rooms look pretty much the exact fucking same. What the fuck? Just simple two-screen rooms. The two rooms are nearly identical. Yeah, it sucks. There's only one other 30 minutes away in the opposite direction. I mean, hey, 30 minutes isn't that far. Hell, every town with, like, stuff in it is at least half an hour away from me. I live in the fucking woods. The closest town to me is 5 minutes away, but it's a small, small-ass town. With no, like, major stores except for, like, a local grocery store. And even then, like, you can't, well, yeah. I'll put it this way. I cannot buy magic cards in the town that's closest to me, which is 5 minutes. There's none there. There's Pokemon cards and Yu-Gi-Oh cards, but no magic cards, which is dumb. Fair enough, my parents are gonna give me grief over it at some point. Give you grief over what? Some assholes at a shop being dickwads? Like, that's not your fault. Ooh. Another PNG background, but not one that I want to use. A room similar to the one this one appears in the final game, but the gap between the two sides is significantly wider. You know, what do you mean you know this area? It was cut from, oh, the general theme. Yeah, it's the Aztec level from the game. This was also a, these are also two cut bonus rooms. That's where the glitch is done. I mean, it's probably in that world, but but these levels were cut. These were cut bonus levels, specifically. And this is the forest. Yeah, the Aztec level right on that corner area in the actual game. Not in these levels specifically. Yeah, okay, cool. Gotcha. A nice little forest. I could fucking kayfabe that I'm in the woods. Yo, what up, y'all? I'm in this low poly woods. Check it out. Oh, man. Another simple long bonus room that didn't get used. Ooh, these would be cool for, like, winter. But again, it's too out...
What the hell is that?
It's too outdoorsy. That was weird. Anyway. It's done on one of the slopes like that. Tell them bring out the whole wood. Bring out the whole damn woods. Another case of Rare wanting to cover all possible room types here again. Here again are two long bonus rooms that are nearly identical, but for scenery. Yo! The fucking Crystal Caverns! What up? Fuck yeah, dude. Hell yeah, dude. That's what I'm fucking talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Wow. God, that's one of my favorite videos. Me and my sticky buddy. But not too much. You're gonna want to stroke it, but not too much. It'll make a mess. Just do your stream, but it's 90% covered by crystals. Bro, I have so many J.O. crystals, you don't even know. They're so charged. Alright. in what has now become a theme, this two-screen-wide bonus room was never used in-game. The crystal meat? What the fuck does that mean? Oh, hey, this one actually has bananas in it. At first, I misspelled Yono? Huh? At first, a room with objects in it. Woo! I misspelled, you know. Oh, okay. This looks like an alternate version of a bonus room that actually appears in the final game. In the final version, you climb down ropes that move you either up or down. At the end of each rope is a nanner bunch. The room here is essentially flipped vertically, so you mainly be climbing up ropes instead of climbing down. Room 4, hey, we're getting industrial. Tired of these yet? Ha ha ha. Is that just like a regular blank platform? It is. Oh, that's funny. Oh, God. Just use this as like a fucking elevator. This might not even be a bonus room, but it's grouped with them in the factory layout. No idea what this could have been used for. A barrel silhouette? What the fuck? What barrel silhouette? There's no barrel silhouette. Either way, wow. We got through the pre-release info and unused rooms in an hour and a half, almost. Asuka and Rei seem like... Huh? Asuka? I haven't seen Evangelion. Oh, it's the fucking Dirtly Kirk balloon. Oh, the elevator scene. Yes, I remember that. One of my favorites is whenever they put Carl, I think his name is, from Aqua Teen Hunger Force. They're just sitting there for like, and he's looking around and then frowning, and he's like, it don't matter. None of this matters. Ah! I hit my phone and it dropped. I love that meme so fucking much. It don't matter. I should try to find that on sound alerts. So I need the yippee and the it don't matter. Oh, I love it. Oh, so good. It's so weird how often Toby uses the same leitmotifs for a lot of things. I found the It Don't Matter clip on YouTube. I found it on YouTube a while ago. I was looking for the sound clip for sound alerts. Ippin's Cat. Oh, it's Final Fantasy IX! An alternate version of the one-up balloon. Yeah, this one looks brown and weird. Oh, I can make it an MP3. Like I said, Cosmic, I don't even know if it's on the sound alert board yet. I need to find it. If it's not, then you can work on that. But I don't want you to, you know, do all that work for nothing. both of these fish. It's Marlin and Weird Door. Oh, I like that. Clownfish, other fish. I'm not familiar with that breed. Both of these fish make an appearance in the GBA version of Donkey Kong Country as decorative objects in the underwater levels. However, they don't appear anywhere in the SNES version. Note that the correct palettes for these fish don't exist in the ROM. The first should look like a clownfish, while the species of the second fish hasn't been identified yet. Nemo and Not Dory. Nanners. Old Avenger of a Nanner. 17 Nanners. Bonus letters. Fajlkvs. These types of letters are used for bonus rooms. Yes, are used for bounce rounds. Some planks of wood. Some drum barrels. Exit. Fuel barrels. Oh, that looks kind of creepy. Jungle plant. Open and closed. Oh, shoot. I like that. Fucking lightning bolt. Not the... Yes! It's time for the coveted Cadicurus Bounds Round! Oh my god, that's one of my favorite fucking bits that he's ever done. Another one of my favorites is, it's time for another edition of Let's Get Fit with Kadiki Dick! I cannot believe that man was born the same year I was, and I was born a month before him! His birthday's in June, mine's in May. I cannot believe we are the same age! Holy shit, dude. I feel closer to him knowing that we're the same age. I don't know why, he lives all the way in England, and he will probably never meet me. I'd love to meet him, though.
Cash B-A-N-O-O-K-A.
Cash B-A-N-O-O-K-A. It's Cash Banuka! Oh, man, have you seen any of his streams? They're really good. He has all of his own personal, sound alerts, emotes. It's so good. Of course, he has the Cone Man death. The fucking beep, beep, beep. Yes, he does streams. He has a VODs channel, but he hasn't streamed in a little while. It's been a couple of months since he streamed, but he does have a VODs channel. They're very, very silly to watch. I like it. I'm only gonna watch this later. Yeah, his playthrough of Crash Bandicoot Wrath of Cortex was fucking hilarious. It's great. Alright. While the lightning effect is used in Ropey Rampage. There we go. I only got Twin Sanity for my PS2 since of him. Cosme, you are still the only person that I've ever met who still uses the phrase since of in that manner. It's fascinating to see. I used to have Twin Sanity, and then I got tired of playing it, and I didn't think I would ever want to play it again. Here I am, 15 years later, wishing I hadn't sold it. Anyway, in Ropey Rampage, the lightning bolt object is not used. Using the code that in any other jungle level will display the bolt. It seems to have been manually disabled by Ropey from Ropey Rampage before release. I can lend you my PS2 copy. Isn't that the good one? I think it's the good one, but I don't want... Dude, I don't want you to sit. I don't want you to pay shipping just to let me borrow something. That seems kind of silly. I do not mind if it's plans for streams. I get that. I we'll see. I can get cheap ship. I mean, that's fair. Like I said, we'll see. Hold on, let me see how much Twin Sanity is on eBay, because if it's not that much, then I'm gonna buy it. Def, I got a lot of games on backlog I won't get to. That's fair. Oh yeah, that's not bad at all. Complete inbox is only about $20 with 4-day free shipping. Free 4-day shipping. With the manual, it's even cheaper. Free returns, 4-day shipping. Yeah, $14.87. Dude, that's fucking... With manual! I spent $5 on mine, sir. I can help you. I mean, look.
I like having the manual, and it seems, you know, $14 is not that, $15 is not that much, even if it's, like, you know, up, even if it's inflated a little bit, I don't mind. If it were, like, 50, yeah, no. Absolutely not. Also, you probably bought yours at a fucking flea market, Cosme. Nah, it ain't. Alright, man, just let me know and not get... Wow. Somehow it just had a random PS2 game in the on the shelf. Like, how long ago was this? Because if this was, like, within a couple of years ago, then yeah, I get why it was $5. They were trying to get rid of it. Somehow I just had a 4-ish back when the first Crash Month video dropped, whether you mentioned it, I think. So, okay, no, that wasn't 4 years ago, was it? I don't think he started Crash Bandicoot 4 years ago. It had to have been, well, wait, hold on. 3, 2, oh yeah, 2019 was 4 years ago. Even then, PS2 games at GameStop in 2019? That's crazy. I can't believe they still had games back then. Ooh, I just saw in a Discord, they're making Hilda Season 3! I'm so happy! I love Hilda! It's such a cute show! Oh, I love Hilda. Goobers are sleeping. I'm gonna go and do what I usually do at night when waifu isn't home. Order takeaway and binge Chopped. Oh, God. Oh, I mean, hey, Aiden, if Hilda... Hilda for the win! And, I mean, look, Aiden, if it makes you happy, if it relaxes you, go do it. I was gonna say something more clever, but, you know, go watch that Chop. Go watch that Chippy Chop cooking show thing. Doing a heckin' lurk. Hello, Amma! Thank you for lurking. Enjoy yourself. I'm looking at early and cut content from the original Donkey Kong Country. Can't eat pizza. Oh, that sucks. I'm so sorry, Aiden, that you cannot eat pizza. What a world to live in. Why are you Aiden pewing? Cosme. Is this what I think? Oh, no, it's not. Okay, it's Night Runner. I thought it was more, Heartburn. It's a real bitch to deal. I don't think... Oh, never mind. Aiden, for some reason, my dumbass thought that was Cosmic mentioning Heartburn. Because it's my only Aiden. It's the only one you need, Cosme. Aiden Pugh is the only emote you need. Yeah. Pew, pew, pew. It's the only emote I have done. It's an army of Glock wielding dryads. The little boo boo keys. What do you mean boo boo keys, dude? That's one of my favorite goddamn scenes from SpongeBob. Boo boo keys. I don't know why I sounded like a crotchety old man. Not crotchety, but a crazy old man just then. Old man McGucket, local kook. All right. I don't know what the fuck that is, but it's waggling back and forth. Interesting. Oh, wait. What is this? Feather. Oh, okay. There's a cute as fuck rabbit someone draws named Boo Boo Key. I love that. Interestingly enough, this object does appear in the GBA port of Donkey Kong Country. There, they spawn after a Neki, I don't know what the fuck that is, has been killed. Something similar might have happened in the SNES version. That's a squished ass Nintendo logo. Good lord. Squeesh. No pointer, but graphics are stored in ROM. A small, wide... Yeah, you damn right it's wide.
a small, wide version of the Nintendo. Oh, that reminds me. I don't know how many of y'all watch Sea Dog VA, but he has a toggle on his Steam Deck where the camera just zooms in and widens his face. And I want that so bad. I love the going wide. The taggle. What the fuck? Yes, the wide toggle. That's one of my favorite things that he does, and I want that wide toggle so bad. Just to turn my PNG like super fucking wide. Like as a reaction to stuff, like really? Oh man, that'd be funny as hell. Love that. Alright. Probably would have been displayed in the SNES's pseudo hires. What? Pseudo high res. Jesus. That's a wide ass. Help, I'm. No! Come on! I don't know how many of y'all can see that, but it says, help, I'm being oppressed. God fucking damn it. Help, I'm being oppressed. Oh, you've gotta be. I think that's a fucking Powerpuff Girls reference. Oh my god. No pointer, but graphics are starting around strange, wide letters that don't appear to have any purpose. Yes, oppressed. Help, I'm being oppressed. Those four letters are repeated several times in one chunk of the ROM. That's weird. Ooh, we got some fire. Oil barrel. Oh, wait, that next one's a spoiler. The oil barrels used in the game were originally smaller, the same size as the dumb drums. Weird name. Both the flame and the drum grew in size by the final version. Look at the spinny! Look at the fucking spinny horn. The spinny doot doot. I love this thing so fucking much. Fuck it. I'm gonna download this. Spin. I'm gonna download it and just make it a free emote. Cause it's beautiful. Look how small it is. Holy shit. What is this? Oh, it's Arcana 13. Horn E-Spin, come on. Yeah, this is Italian occult horror doom metal. It's doom metal that's from Italy that has lyrical themes of the occult and horror. I love them. I remember seeing this dope as fuck album in Portugal, but it didn't have the vinyl, so I left it. Oh, it looked metal as fuck. I'll send the pic I took in the. Oh, you found this album cover? Dude, that's awesome! You found Italian occult horror doom metal band Arcana 13's album, Danza Macabra. No different. Oh, my bad. Still, though, I would love to find this on vinyl. Or at least cassette, because my record player comes with a cassette player. Alright, the honk has been downloaded. That's a spiky fish. No pointer, but graphics are stored in ROM. This is the Puff Tup enemy, which appears in DKC2, but not the original Donkey. Wait, hold on. I got so excited by the toot toot that I didn't even read the description. Spinning graphics of the phonograph horn, possibly meant to be used in the game intro after the boombox drops down.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, this is the Puff Tup enemy, which appears in DKC2. But not the original Donkey Kong Country. But not in the original Donkey Kong Country. Its palette appears in the ROM as well, where it has a blue coloring not seen in DKC2 version. Only the idle animation exists in the Donkey Kong Country ROM. Okay, so this is meant to be blue, but on my stream preview, it's purple, and I don't know why. This is the same color. This is the same shade of blue. This is purple for some reason on my end. I have no clue why. Yo, this boy cringe. Check out this fuck. It's the fucking supernatural, like ghost hunting arrow.
Do you see it in the corner? Do you see it?
Oh man, a red arrow, albeit without a sign. What's up, demons? It's your boy, Red Arrow Man. Point. I kind of wish I could just download this and have it on standby. Just be like, yo, check this shit out. Look how wacky that is, right? Alright. Powered by MediaWiki. Creative Commons. Oh, okay. Sent the cover art in IRL pics, by the way. It's so damn cool. Alright, now I gotta see this. Alright, let's see what you got. Memes, there it is. Oh, that's just a regular ass metal band. There was a band called Halloween from the 80s. I don't remember what subgenre of metal they were, but they were a real band. Like, it's not like an indie band. I thought you were for some reason I thought you were talking about a I wish I just took the I mean, that's fair. But apparently, yeah, apparently Halloween is a very classic heavy metal band from the 80s. In a lot of, heavy metal circles. Jesus. Brain farting all over the place. Goddamn. Okay. Depending on who's still streaming, I might... Well, we'll see. I'm getting ahead of myself, but yeah. Alright, wait, who posted in fucking memes? Oh my god! I just saw the Patrick surrounded by gemstones. I've never seen that before. I love that. It's a German heavy metal band. Yeah, okay, cool. It don't matter. None of this matters. Real screen cap from an episode. I love that. It doesn't look new. It looks old, but I don't remember this scene. That's crazy. But yes, they made this. Boo boo key. Whoa! I just saw boo boo keys. Wow, that's really cute. I also like the crack rabbit. That looks cool as hell. What are you talking about? Alright. Anyway. So we have got... Oh, wow. That's... Really? Are we really about to finish... Are we really about to finish... the look-through of... Crab Rabbit Mood. Yeah. Are we seriously about to finish the entire... DKC TCR page? Hold on, I have to sneeze. Oh god, that one hurt my throat. Oh. Oh god. Also, Cosme, what the fuck, bro? Oh god. Ugh. Best achievement so far this month. Oh my god. Oh my god! I fucking love that sound, meme. Oh my god! They almost. Hey, you almost finished the page. Hell yeah, I did. Alright. Unused objects. You sound like Carl Weezer.
Jimmy's mom.
Nah, people think his voice is that high pitched, but it's a little lower. I'm trying to think of a specific
scene where he talks a lot. Where he's not screaming. Jimmy? It's kind of like that.
Why is it when we go to the bathroom it takes us like 2 minutes, but for girls it takes like 15?
It's slightly higher than that.
Oh, yeah. Excuse me, but are you going to finish that quassel?
I can't do his fucking screams, though. Ruby Madness! Oh, I can, actually. Holy shit. Ruby Madness! Ruby Madness! I clipped the mic so bad, I apologize. You can clip that. Alright. Ugh. I had the fucking sneeze. Does anyone else get small burps after they sneeze? That happens. That started happening to me recently, and it's really fucking weird. A dirt patch. A critter. What a name. A zinger. That's a mincer. Look at the beaver boy. I just get hiccups plus burps after I sneeze or breathe the wrong way that makes it so I can't breathe. Damn, bro.
Billabop.
You got some issues there? Crush a big boy. Oh, that's Necky. It's the vulture. It's hell yeah. I got over 800. 800, like, breathing problems? If so, goddamn, boy. Oh, speaking of arrow... It's your boy, the Pokety Poke. Alright. There's Necky flying. Oh, that's Mankey Kong. He looks like the fucking jerk from the Donkey Kong animated series. Which you want? Gwen Stacy... Huh? Gwen Stacy Annual Spider-Man 99... I guess Gwen Stacy Annual? Issues, I have it. Oh, I thought you meant fucking health issues, goddammit. Don't fuck with me like that. I care about your health, goddammit. An upside down barrel. A flappy necky. Barrel. More G Fuel. A rock croc? What? That guy looks fucking weird. No, I got a lot. That's fair. Flying. Where are you seeing flying nuts from? Backwards. Scroll up. Scroll up to where? The bird? Okay. Oh, oh man, I'm so glad you caught that. Firing. Yeah, don't you see him, Cosme? Those are his big old flying nuts there. They're swinging in the breeze. Oh man, wow. That is not a lot. We are already almost done with this. But then again, like I said, the scrolly little bar is like right here where my mouse is. Oh wait, hold on, might as well get the version differences out of the way. Just in case. Oh, okay, it's just like... Oh, here we go. Honestly, I like the Japanese version. I like the... Wait. Last time I checked, this so-called Donkey Kong country hasn't been officially recognized by the UN. It set it up a bit. What? Huh. Also, see. Better image... Oh, US 1.2. It is no longer possible to skip the fanfare when beating a level for the first time. In a case of how did the developers not catch that, most of the mini Neckies had no collision whatsoever, meaning you could safely jump through them without taking any damage. Wait, the one above. Which bullet point are you referring to, Cosme? There's three of these, and one up here. 1, 2, 3. The first one in 1.1. Huh? The first one. So this one? Entering a bonus. Okay. A glitch was fixed, which allows the player to trade an animal friend for Rambi. The exact directions are quite verbose, but involve entering a bonus area containing an animal friend while riding another one, jumping on the provided animal friend, jumping off, and exiting, which will cause Donkey Diddy to appear with Rambi. Weird. Whew. But yeah, I love that. That's so much cooler. Better image, worse title. That's the funny glitch. That's it? You swap out Rambi with anybody? Or swap out any animal for Rambi? The one where it looks like DK is humping Got it. It's the humpy glitch. The classic. I don't really see a difference. Spot the difference, y'all. What the fuck is different? Other than the text. The text doesn't count. I just told you the text doesn't count, boy. Listen when people speak. Also, you said kanju, which is hilarious. That was delayed. Oh, my bad. I don't really see any differences. I spent so much time as a kid trying to get to that icon, hoping for a secret world. Mystery solved. No difference. When starting a new game, Donkey moves from a starting position to the first world. In the international version, there is an icon at this position and a path from it were removed in the Japanese version. The Japanese version refers to the worlds as numbered levels. Oh, I see what they're saying. So, in the English version, you see this is your starting point, but then DK walks over here to the first level, but in the Japanese level, there's not this path. The path is gone, and you're just at the first level. There's no, like, overworld theming. It's just a series of numbered levels. Also, in the Japanese version, there's an exclamation mark after the word level name if you've found all bonuses, and another exclamation mark after a beaten boss stage. Sweet. Level changes. Found all bonus. Oh, found all bounds. All bounds found in this round. Okay. That's a lot of minor changes. Good lord. Whoop, hold on. A banana crunch is now awarded for every third hand slapped enemy, including crushes. That's funny. It's possible to kill rock crocs by using Donkey's ground slap move. I'm so gonna watch Caddy after this while editing for a bit. You know what? Fair, man. I love Caddy. Mm-hmm. When they are curled up, activated by stop and go stations red light, this feature would be added in all versions of the GBA port. Ooh, that makes it a lot easier. I'm still getting the sneezy burps. Weird. Diddy Kong must jump on a Mankey Kong enemy twice to kill it. That's weird. Hitting it the first time freezes him in place with an early frame of his death animation while pushing back Diddy, like jumping on a clump, while the second hit is a normal kill. Weird. Ooh, Virtual Console changes. The Virtual Console version makes a change to Torchlight Treble. In the SNES version, when the Kongs would change direction, Squawks would turn his flashlight to face the screen. During this time, there would be a blinding flash where the entire screen would turn white for one frame, forcing players to close their eyes. Oh my god. What a fucking shitty oversight.
the parrot. Also, that feels so non-diegetic. I think, I can't remember if it's diegetic or non-diegetic. Whichever one means, like, it's very fourth wall-y. Not the Disney character. Fourth wall-esque. Because it's like, the parrot is acknowledging you by flashing you in the fucking face with a flashlight. Oh my god. Cannot believe they programmed that. That's very funny. Competition cart. Glitches. Alright. Ooh, unused music. Fuck yeah. Oh yeah. I'm so damn big. Alright. Damn it. Okay. What do we got here? An early version of the boss music found in US 1.0. It begins at a slower pace than the final boss music, but gradually increases in tempo until about halfway through the third loop, when it is close to the final version's pace. This song also has different instrument pointers compared to any of the used songs, hence the sample pointers had to be changed for the SPC file for it to play correctly. Ooh, I like that drum. I like it. Ooh, I love the spooky vibes. This doesn't even sound intense. It just sounds like relaxing in a spooky way. Like, I would love to sit in a chair and pitch in a pitch black room and close my eyes listening to this. This is fucking awesome. Like, you could fucking rap over this. Are you kidding me? I love this. All right. And this is an early version of the map music with placeholders for some instruments. This version uses the cranking sound that some enemies make, such as armies as they rev up, in place of the bass, while an out-of-key synth is used instead of the flute. That's funny. I gotta hear those now. It sounds farty. Oh my god. My man thumping. Yeah, the horn. Oh my god, the horn sounds drunk as fuck. Boop, boop. Ooh. This feels like if Vinny did a corruption on DKC1. Yeah, absolutely it does. That's very funny. Unused sounds, fuck yeah. Several sound effects exist which are never heard in the game. Use the PAR code that to replace the sound effect when collecting bananas with one of these, where the question mark should be replaced with one of the following values. That's weird. Sounds like a pitch-shifted Grant Kirkhope. I'm jizzing. All right. A voice click. Yeah. Oh, it's gulping. A voice. Sounds like the dude who voiced Yoshi, but not Paige. Oh, I love that video. Yoshi, bring ha. Ow, wow, 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 wow. Oh my god, I love that so much. Okay, a duplicate of the last sound but with higher notes. Huh. Weird. A percussion sample that echoes once. Okay. That sure is what that is. A looped bubble sound. That sounded like Toad. Vaguely. Not that one.
Yeah, it sounds vaguely like it sounds like a higher pitched in Nintendo 64 Toad, which, oh my god, I miss the N64 era Toad. He sounded so much better than the current version. I hate how scratchy his voice is. Okay, let's see. Oh, that sounds like a healing sound, doesn't it? It sounds like you cast Cure 1 in Final Fantasy. Yeah, for real. Or like a buff of some kind. I want a Mario TV show, Toad. Oh, god, no. A high-pitched whine that oscillates in pitch. Uh-oh, get ready. Oh, that sounds creepy. You put some distortion on that with like some creepy music and atmosphere. That's some psychological horror shit right there. What the fuck? I hate that. I hate that. This would be good for a boss man, for a booze mansion. That sound? I mean, maybe for like a second or two, but not that long. An arpeggio that fades in volume. Oh, that's an arpeggio. N64 Boo Mansion, yeah. Since it's so... I mean, I don't mind the Boo Mansion in Mario 64. It's not as bad as it looks, in my opinion. The piano section, the piano monster is classic. Oh, that's the thing. Okay, never mind. Anything better than the circus music? Oh my god, yeah, I hated that circus music. What appears to be a note scale test, a cranking sample is looped in a sequence of rising notes, revealing aliasing as the sound gets higher before turning into a series of seemingly random pitches. These random pitches are the result of reading bits out loud, bytes out loud? Bytes outside of the note pitch table as pitch values. With booze, oh yeah, that's awful. Oh, that's kind of creepy. Oh, that's unsettling. Oh, that's weird. What in the fuck? It doesn't sound like it's going up any higher. Emma. Okay. Okay. I thought I was going to get jump scared by that random assortment of pitches. Sounds like I'm gonna die for fucking real. It's wow, one last noise. You know what it fucking sounds like? It sounds like someone took the feeling of that you're about to pass out or barf or both and then put it into sound form. That's literally what that feels like. Oh my god. Ooh boy. That queasy cold sweat feeling. Where, like, you want to close your eyes because it hurts, but you know if you close your eyes for too long, you'll pass out. That twitch sound, no! Absolutely not! Oh my god, dude. People would hate that. The Vine Boom! The Vine Boom is a classic circa 2016. Love the Vine. I'm so glad the Vine Boom was preserved. Let's listen to that one more time. Oh, yeah. I feel like this would make some people ill. I could not do this to somebody. Not even for a monetary value. And that pause in between is so unsettling. Because you don't know where it's going. God, that one last one at the end is so weird. Alright, let's see. First channel, 71, 72 second channel. A little fanfare produced by layering two sound effects. Random video game fact. Let me see if I can remember one. The
I had to get you on that. No problem, dude. So, the side or subsidiary, or I don't know what you'd call it, but there was a development team that was created around 2001, 2002, called Activision O2. They were tasked specifically with making sequels to the Tony Hawk's Pro Skater series, which they started with Pro Skater 3 and then made 4, but they also made the Tony Hawk's Pro Skater clones, such as Sean Palmer's Pro Snowboarder, Kelly Slater's Pro Surfer, a wakeboarding one, and a dirt bike one, I believe, and Matt Hoffman's Pro BMX 2. There were, however, I think there was at least one or two games that were canceled because the games did not sell nearly as well as people as the company thought they would, which sucks because, you know, by themselves, they're not bad games. You know, they are clones of Pro Skater, but I enjoy them for what they are. And they're nice to just, you know, enter some cheat codes and dick around for a while. Obviously, that's not the reason everyone plays games. They play games to, you know, victories or whatever, but I mean, sometimes it just depends on the game. And the Pro Skater clones are just one of those games where you enter cheat codes and you just dick around. You have some fun. And no, they did not make Simpsons Skateboard. The game that I know of off the top of my head that was canceled by Activision O2 is Sean Palmer's Pro Snowboarder 2, which I am so butthurt about because I have every single PS2 Activision O2 game that was ever released. And in one of the cases, there's a little secondary ad book specifically to promote Activision O2's upcoming games. And one of those games was Sean Palmer's Pro Snowboarder 2. And, like, before I realized it was canceled, this was years after it canceled, but I didn't realize it at the time, but I was like, yo, they made a second one? Fuck yeah! But then I went to Google it, and then I found, like, an old article where it was like, oh, canceled. Like, god fucking damn it. That's my Madden 08. I don't know. I don't play the Madden games. But yeah, that's one thing to note about Activision O2. You will immediately recognize their splash screen if you play Pro Skater 3 or 4, because if you were a kid and you played Pro Skater 3 or 4 and you had the volume up on your TV, the fucking splash animation for Activision O2 would fucking jump scare you with, like, harsh guitars and drums. Like, just out of nowhere you would get did you have the Snowboarder 2 Game Boy Color? No, I only have the PS2 versions of the games. I do have Matt Hoffman's Pro BMX 1, though, which is not a bad game. It's janky, but eh. And SSS... Damn, I never grew up with him. If you mean SSX, that was not made by Activision. That was made by EA. I do have SSX Tricky 3 and On Tour for the PlayStation 2, and I will be playing through all three of them once we get there. Because we just have to get through Sly 3, and then after that, we will start The Simpsons Skateboarding, but we're not going to play through the whole thing, because it's, the game is too janky to finish, but with cheat codes, it's nice to have fun. Now that's me saying SSS Sense of the Sound, yeah, okay, yeah, the jump scare, yeah. I really should play... Man, now... Man. Like a hit. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I see what you mean. Now I really want to turn the Activision O2 music sound into a fucking sound alert. Oh, my God. And just name it Activision O2 Jump Scare. But I don't know if Activision will actually allow us to do that. I don't see why they wouldn't, since they haven't used it in almost 20 years, but you know how fickle Activision can be. They're a shit company. Especially now that they're Activision Blizzard. Ugh.
Wait.
But, you know. Well, then again, it wouldn't hurt to try. Because I'm pretty sure whenever you submit a sound alert to Twitch, it scans it and is, you know, it does like the copyright checks for you. So if it's not allowed, then Twitch will just kind of block it from being uploaded anyway. So I would love to turn the Activision O2 splash sound into a sound alert. Then the alert's only is like less than 10 seconds long, I think. It's like a couple second riff, and then you hear Activision O2. Oh, it's so fucking good. Anyway. A little fanfare produced by layering two sound effects. The same method is used for the fanfare played when revealing hidden bonus area entrances.
I like
that. Sound effect oddities. In Tanked Up Trouble, the sample that is supposed to be used for the sound effect that plays when the tank platform loses fuel is not loaded. Thus, the sound effect changes depending on which levels were visited prior to Tanked Up Trouble. Here is how it should sound when the correct sample is loaded. Oh. Similarly, in Snow Levels and Boss Dumb Drum, the steel keg clanging sound sample, ID12, is not loaded, even though the sound effect that calls for it is. In the latter case, even though steel kegs do not appear in boss levels, their sound effect is used when Dumb Drum bounces off the ground. I keep wanting to say fucking Cum Drum, which is so dumb. Oh my god. Sound cycle. Okay, back to the music. Let's lower the volume just in case. There we are. Sound cycle. Highlight erase game on the file select menu and press down A R B Y down A Y. Once the code is entered correctly, you will hear a fanfare for confirmation. Press select, and the screen will briefly blank until it plays DK Island Swing. Press select again to cycle through a set selection of. Yo, you can unlock the fucking sound library. Sweet. Debug functions, yep. Classic debug mode. Yep. Debug. Free movement debug, yep. Yep. Things. Map error checking. The overworld map will display error when there is no text string associated with that room ID. Cum num drum. This is a real cum numdrum. You're right, Cosme. It's a fucking cum numdrum. Okay. This is also present in the Game Boy Color port. Unused room ID, that thing right there. Unused animations and frames, fuck yeah. Dirtly Kirk doing some different shit. When the mods are away, there will be a cum numdrum. Oh, man. Oh, I love that. There will be, when the mods are away, there will be a cum numdrum. Oh, boy. I love that. Oh, that's cool. Oh! An unused animation similar to one of DK's attacks in Donkey Kong 64. Yeah, I thought that looked familiar. It's the forward kick. I love that one. Yes, yeah, so once I eventually play and sort of finish DK64, we will be looking at it. Also, as soon as I finish Sly 3, the Cum Num Drum will reign supreme. Oh, God. But yeah, once we finish Sly 3, we'll be looking through the TCRF page for that as well. But I don't know how big it is. That's what she said. Sweet. Cranky. He walking. Cranky Kong is never seen walking in the... Oh, yeah, he's always in the rocking chair.
Not gonna lie, I can't wait for you to crack into some other fun PS2 game. Hell yeah, brother. I can go ahead and tell you what's on the docket after Sly 3 right now. Looking up at my shelf, we have The Simpsons Skateboarding, Sonic Mega Collection, which the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to play Sonic 1 through 3 and then Knuckles, and I'm going to play, but if I get a game over with no continues, then I'm going to switch to the next game in the line. That way I don't take forever playing through all the old Sonic games that everyone has seen before. I will look at the comic covers, though. I fucking love the comic covers. I got Twinsanity, Katamari 1 and 2, and a few others for you to play. I don't like Katamari. I like watching people play it, but I don't like the gameplay style. It's not my thing. The twin stick thing, I can't get into that. After Sonic Mega Collection, though, we will have Soul Calibur 2 and 3. I don't know if I want to do arcade mode or what with that, but I cannot wait to do Soul Calibur 2 and 3. After that, ooh, is a racing game specifically using Sea-Doos called Splashdown Rides Gone Wild. I remember wanting that game so badly as a kid. I also got the theme park roller coaster as well. All the theme park tycoon or whatever, I never liked those games. I mean, fair, dude. If you grew up on it, that's understandable. But I never grew up on Roller Coaster Tycoon, and those sorts of management simulator type games were never appealed to me. Hey, man, it's all right. After Splashdown, we will have a miniature SpongeBob marathon with SpongeBob SquarePants: The Revenge of the Flying Dutchman, the first SpongeBob game on PS2, and the game that sold so badly the developer went out of business, which sucks because I like the game. It's fun despite the jank. After that, we have SpongeBob SquarePants Battle for Bikini Bottom, not Creature from the Krusty Krab. After Battle for Bikini Bottom, we will have SpongeBob SquarePants The Movie The Game, which is essentially a shorter but upgraded version of Battle for Bikini Bottom. And then after the SpongeBob marathon, it will be an SSX marathon with SSX Tricky 3 and On Tour. And after that, we will have the original Star Wars Battlefronts 1 and 2. Lovely. Then we'll have Tekken 4 and 5. Although, sir, I got so many to add to this. I also got Lights Pants Action. No, I don't like Lights Camera Pants. There are also some PS2 games that are not in PS2 cases. They're in jewel cases, which I will play. But I think it's SOSP. So after Soul Calibur 3, we will be playing Spider-Man: The Movie, The Game with Tobey Maguire, and then Spider-Man 2: The Movie, The Game. Although I don't know if we're gonna finish Spider-Man 2: The Movie, The Game because that's a long one. What else? I think that's all. Codes for what? Because I have cheat code books. I've got the codes for that in cheat code books. Since the playthroughs are so short, because some of the levels are so hard and bad that I just skip them, I will do one playthrough as... I call it the Superior Spider-Man because... excuse me. Paper with them. Hell yeah. I call it the Superior Spider-Man suit because it's like a darker looking suit that looks like Superior Spider-Man. I'm gonna play the game with that suit, and then I'm going to play the game as Green Goblin. The MJ kissing MJ is just kind of whatever. It's not a big deal. It is kind of silly to watch, though. One Piece Grand. Yes, thank you, Cosme, for reminding me. I have One Piece Grand Battle and I have every character. I've been meaning to buy the sequel too, One Piece Grand Adventure, I think it's called. But yeah, I absolutely have One Piece Grand Battle. I love One Piece Grand Battle. Fucking love that game, dude. Complete with Goku as the narrator. One Piece Grand Battle. I actually might send my PS2. What the fuck? I need a finished save. Oh, the memory card? Yeah, absolutely. No problem. I've unlocked every character.
which include the big secret characters are Crocodile and I hate that I forgot his name. He's such a cool character. Mr. Two and Miss, you know what I mean? The character that's both a Mr. and a Mrs. and I cannot think of his name. Bon Clay. Those are the two big secret characters. It's Shanks, Mihawk, Bon Clay, and Crocodile. Yeah, you're gonna like Bon Clay. I don't remember how. I think it's via like secret codes that you get once you finish a game. Yeah, now I remember. So I looked this up because I was like, why the fuck don't I have Crocodile or Bon Clay? There's gotta be a way. You either do a time trial or arcade mode in. Yeah, you have to play as a specific character, and then during their victory screen, you input a code which unlocks that character, or which unlocks the either Bon Clay or Crocodile, which is fucking crazy to me. Like, hell, like, I don't think it goes past the Alabasta arc in that game. Yeah, I don't think it goes past the Alabasta arc. Because there's nothing Skypiea related in the game. Japanese Grand Battles are so fun to... I don't think I've ever played the Japanese Grand Battles. But yeah, absolutely, I need to play one Grand Battle. They're 2D fighting games on the PS... Oh, that's the dream right there, baby. Because I loved the original Naruto Ultimate Ninja games that were 2D fighters. The fucking Ultimate Ninja Storm games that are the dumbass arena battle games, I don't like those. Now, granted, One Piece Grand Battle is similar, but it's less... The arena is smaller, which I like more. And they have three, and the third one goes to Skypiea. Ooh, I like that. I like that a lot. But yeah, One Piece Grand Battle and Grand Adventure are clones of a Dreamcast game called Power Stone, if you've ever heard of that. Same exact gameplay and everything. I've never played it, but it looks fun. All right, now that we've been sufficiently distracted. If you ever mod your PS2, I can always slide you the disc. Slide into my disc M's. No. Oh, that's cool. A barrel that gets broken apart. Is he slapping you? He fucking Necky's slapping you. That's funny. Slap. 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 This animation is an earlier design of the nut. Oh, he's throwing nuts. I just gotta show you how to do the stuff and run them. And he slap. Oh yeah, how can she slap? How can she slap? Oh, it's nut throwing Necky. It has the coloring of Necky, but the proportions of mini Necky. This could mean that the two final designs branched off from this one. Oh! 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 Ha! Ha! Okay. It's so silly. Ha! Alright. Queen Bee's hit animation has a good number of unused frames that give the animation a much more fluid look. It does look more fluid, yeah. Oh, that's weird. Two frames versus the extra frame. Extra frames. Rambi actually has more unused frames of his charge animation than used ones. In-game, only two frames of animation were used, while he actually has eight frames. It's eight frames in total. Dedicated to charging. Only DKC2 bumps the charge animation up to 5 frames, using some but not all of the unused frames from here. What a fucking look at that wiggly boy! I love him. I really hope I'm not getting sick, man. I never get sick. So far my nose isn't running, but you know. Knock on wood. Bouncy tires. Nanners. You can't get two groups of nanners. My man got a cold. I fucking hope not, bro. What do you mean it's from you? Did you shoot your sneezes all the way from Florida? They were carried northward on low pressure winds. Yes. Lost my brain in the process. What the fuck? Banana clusters. Hey, look. Looks like, oh, those are in like different shapes. That's kind of cool.
Oh my god.
Oh, I love that one and the Wario one. Oh my god. Cannot believe they put that in. They almost put that in the game. Fucking hilarious. Croctopus. Croctopus palette with the brown yellow markings. This game uses.
Oh no.
It's Photoshop Flowey, aka Breakcore Flowey. Careful, you might get be a croctopus. Croctopus. Hell yeah. Fucking love Breakcore the Breakcore song in this. I swear parts of his theme remind me of a title card section of Toonami or Adult Swim. I mean, maybe, like a little bit. Like at the beginning a little bit, maybe. Well, never mind. If I remember correctly, I specifically remember there being some Breakcore music on the bumpers. That's what it is, the bumpers. Because they would have random-ass music from different indie artists on there. They had Clowncore on there, and if you're not familiar with Clowncore, I highly recommend Clowncore. Oh my god, it's a duo who dress up in clown masks and boiler suits. Not to be confused with Slipknot. Yeah, you know Clowncore! Fuck yeah, I love that band, dude! They fucking rip! They are, like, clearly two very talented musicians that are mixing, like, complex rhythms with shit posts, and it's so fucking good. Anyone? Actually, wait a sec. Well, never mind. I think they're under Adult Swim Records, which is heavily copyrighted. I want to double check though, because like if they're not, oh my god, dude. Clowncore, Van. Oh, that's very funny. The copyright for the album Van by Clowncore is the letter 8, 3 equal signs, and a capital D, which is just a fucking wiener. I'm gonna call that as being independent. I love that. That's fucking hilarious. Oh, they're already on my fucking playlist, but I haven't seen them. What the fuck, dude? Give me some fucking... I'm gonna put the whole album on there. Fuck it. Suck it. No. I'm gonna add it to the queue. Oh, are we back? Maybe? Come on. Oh my god. My KBS is down real low. Ba-ba-da. Oh my god, what in the fuck? Wow. Okay, we're back to green. So far so good, but we're about halfway down the page. We're at the Croco Boys with them. So I'm going to end stream here. Well, no, I want to listen to Clowncore some, so we're going to... Okay, so, fucking love Clowncore, and while we listen to Clowncore, I'm looking for someone to raid. Duh, duh, duh. Hell yeah. Okay, so I want to raid somebody that's in the same Discord server as same Discord server as Gloop Queen, and that is Fire Mountain. It looks like their name is. I don't know though. We'll see. Cause Valdi's. Oh fuck! No, I haven't raided Valdi in forever, dude. I'm gonna raid the Valdi. So we're gonna raid the Valdi. Thank you, Cosme. The raid has started, or it's been created. Thank you to anybody who happened to stop by, and a big thank you to anyone, even if it was just for a second. I hope you've enjoyed this silly-ass stream, and I hope you have a wonderful weekend. I will try to enjoy my weekend. Hopefully I don't get sick, we'll see. Be nice to each other, and yourself. Give yourself a break every once in a while. Don't let that evil voice in your head win. It's wrong if it tells you that you're not good enough. You are good enough. You're awesome. Fuck 'em. I will see y'all this Sunday for more Sly 3. Have a wonderful evening. I'm gonna click raid now as soon as I hit end stream, so bye-bye!